Meantime, here in Metro Atlanta, CBS 46 tracking a crime alert. Good evening, I'm Rick Fulbaum.
And I'm Sean Gables. The search for teenagers who may be on a destructive joyride, they are linked to this school bus crash. CBS 46's Trayson Bragg is at the scene of the crash in Cherokee County with the latest.
Guys, that head-on collision happened right behind me, just feet from where I'm standing. To give you an idea of the impact of this head-on collision, look at these. These are two pieces of the school bus that were left behind after the accident.
It sounded kind of like an explosion or something, you know, you heard metal crunching.
Nicholas Hayden says that sound woke him from his sleep Tuesday morning. What he saw outside his home was even more frightening.
I see the bus directly across from my driveway over here. Off into the ditch.
He sprinted to the crash. He found the driver and one child inside.
You know, offered her help if she wanted to try to get out of the bus because she was leaned to one side and it looked like her door to get out was jammed.
Luckily, no one was hurt. Moments later, Hayden's wife discovered the car officials say caused the accident in his front yard.
And so I run down with my wife to check and see if there's anybody in there. And when we got there, the car was empty.
The steering wheel appeared to have been broken by the body of from the impact of the collision. We saw some blood on the scene.
Officials say the driver ran into the nearby woods. Several hours later, a burgundy van was stolen from a nearby business. They say 17-year-old Timothy Kimbarl and 22-year-old Jordan Payne of Lumpkin County are persons of interest in both investigations.
We won't speak to them, and we haven't had any luck getting in contact with them in person.
The teens are believed to be in a minivan like this with Georgia tag RRW9285. If you know anything, call the Cherokee County Sheriff's Office at 770-720-7079. Guys, get this. Hayden tells me had he not started taking his 8-year-old daughter to school in the mornings about a month ago, she would have been standing right here where I'm standing when the accident happened, just feet from that head-on collision. Reporting in Cherokee County, I'm Trayson Bragg, CBS 46 News.